Coming up, I'm joined by Brad Anderson to look at the latest updates to support secure productivity experiences across devices with Microsoft 365. We're going to look at new options to get managed Windows sessions and apps across devices using Windows Virtual Desktop, streamline management experiences for Microsoft 365 admins, and what you can do to set baseline protections and device configurations in Intune. I'm joined once again by Brad Anderson, CVP at Microsoft. Welcome back.
It's great to be here. I love mechanics.
Thank you. So always device experience and management is a space that continues to evolve, and there are really more options than ever to work from anywhere. What are we doing to make it easier to support and secure the best productivity experience on any device?
Yeah, it all starts with Microsoft 365, and that means it's really all about Windows 10, Office 365 Pro Plus, and then your management and security coming from the cloud. And to be really specific on that, I mean Config Manager Current Branch, or Intune is doing your management.
Right.
Now, one of the characteristics about a modern device is it has this great user experience that also meets the needs from a security compliance perspective from an IT. Now, one of the places I've spent a lot of my time over the last several months is looking into why we have these incredibly long boot time stories that we hear from you know, users in commercial
devices. Yeah, I see that all the time from a lot of people that they've got multiple minute boot times.
You know, the number of times I've heard a customer or an IT leader say, you know, man, it takes me 4 or 5 minutes for my PC to boot. And it's like, well, why? Why is that happening, and how can we help IT understand what they can do to make it a better experience? Because the reality is users are accustomed to immediate on. If my phone, man, I'm working, I want the same thing on my PC.
Right.
And so, you know, as I've looked into this, you know, first and foremost, if you just got poor hardware, that's going to cause a long boot time, you know, spinning media, you don't have enough RAM. But if you've got good hardware, what we have found is the next cause of slow boot times, slow resume, and then why your battery drains so quick is all the agents that get jammed onto a device, and those are predominantly management and security.
Yep.
And so with Microsoft 365, we have built this incredible solution that we think fulfills your needs from a security management and compliance perspective. You can go what we call Microsoft 365 native, using all of our management security, secure the device, it meets the requirements from a compliance and security perspective, but delivers that amazing end user experience. So let me just give you a view of what it looks like. This right here is my actual personal PC. This is AAD joined, Intune enrolled. And again, it meets Microsoft security policies, which is, as you can imagine, our security policies and requirements are high. After all, we have an awful lot of the world's data in our cloud.
Totally.
All right, so I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna power this on. And what I want you to see here is I'm gonna be able to cold boot to productive in 20 seconds.
Okay.
Right, so you see here it's coming up. Windows Hello comes online and authenticates me. And right now, I could literally be bringing up Outlook, Word, be productive. That's the experience we're talking about when we say modern Windows or a modern device. And this is what all of our users, you know, all of your users should expect, what they should get.
Totally. So it's really an awesome example, really, that brings to life the advantages of getting modern with secure and intelligent management for both end users and IT.
That's right. And for users, it means access to the most advanced tools so they can do their very best work in the least amount of time across all of their devices. Now, we're leveraging AI as a part of the productivity experience, so you can focus on the content and less on the formatting, and you get these insights in your data or finding all the relative materials to make your next doc or presentation stand out. We're also using the cloud to get you back to what you were working on or on the files that were shared with you across your devices wherever you are. You know, it's all about making sure the user is immediately productive.
Totally.
For IT, this is all about providing that best experience and keeping it up to date while protecting your data and your users. And here we use the cloud to help enable secure identity as well as access management with things like multi-factor authentication and conditional access. We can even apply conditional management experiences based upon device or apps accessing specific content. So we can apply tighter controls to devices accessing sensitive information or looser controls to those accessing low-risk data. And we can use the power of the cloud to scan your information, help you understand what you're going to want to protect, whether that's at rest or in transit. We can detect anomalous behaviors and even proactively hunt the bad actors out who may have infiltrated your environment.
That's right. So let's switch gears to Windows Virtual Desktop, because we're bringing all these really powerful experiences on mobile devices that are native, also on personal devices and across the browser. Yeah. But where does WVD then fit in here?
Well, first of all, we are really excited about Windows Virtual Desktop, and the interest in the preview has just been off the charts. So Windows Virtual Desktop is the modern Windows experience running in the Microsoft cloud. And there are so many reasons to use remote desktops and applications. And what we're doing here is we are really breaking down many of the barriers, both in terms of the experience and the management, just to make it easier. Whether you want to ensure separation of data from the device, whether you need high bandwidth, low latency connections to data sources, ensure that compute resources are powerful enough in scenarios like engineering, software development, or media production, just to name a few, we have literally been making changes inside of the Microsoft 365 product to ensure that that combination of Windows 10, Office 365, running with Windows Virtual Desktop, and managed and secured by Config Manager and Intune, delivers the absolute best experience for users.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Let's see this in action.
Yeah, let's do it. First, let's walk through the end user experience. We can use any device, you know, iOS, Android, Mac, or Windows, even just a browser. Okay, so Jeremy, why don't you walk through the end user experience, and then I'll show how you set it up and how you configure it.
All right, sounds good. So in my case, I've actually got a Windows 10 device here. And you can see when I click my start menu, I can actually see the different apps that have been provisioned for me by IT. And they're right there next to all the apps that they've provisioned to me for from Configuration Manager. I'm just going to open Excel, for example. And the only thing that's really different here is in the taskbar, you can see a glyph that says it's from Windows Virtual Desktop. When I click on a file, it's nice and responsive. I can even do things like snap the app to one side of the screen alongside a native app, so it even feels native from an end user perspective. So really, really seamless experience there. Another great thing here, so if I go to another desktop, I can go to a full desktop view as well. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the multi-session environment. In here, one of the great things is if I open the entire Windows desktop, in this case for Windows 10, I can do something brand new, which is launch and run Outlook. And one of the things I really love about this is when I fire up Outlook and I'm using it immediately, didn't have to spend any time in terms of hydrating my inbox, but how did all that work?
You know, the file storage and management enhancements are part of work that we've done with the FS Logix acquisition. FS Logix allows you to have that immediate startup experience in OneDrive for Business and in Outlook, as if it was all in a local drive. So users can jump straight into Outlook or OneDrive without waiting for anything to have to hydrate in the cache. It's just immediate. You know, I've known the FS Logix founder, Randy, for almost 30 years. In fact, we sat across from each other in cubicles when we first started taking phone calls and technical support. Mm-hmm. What FS Logix does is it really accelerates and improves that end user experience in a virtual scenario. And if you've worked with VDI in the past where Outlook and OneDrive cache takes time to hydrate and get it moved over, FS Logix solves that. And when the VDI session is provisioned, your cache for Outlook and OneDrive for Business is immediately hydrated. You're just off and running. It's amazing.
So we saw the seamless end user experience, but the thing I'm most excited about is actually the IT experience. So what does it take to get this set up?
Now, as seamless as the user experience was, if you've ever set up remote desktop services, you'll know that the IT experience could use some improvements. So let's show you how we've made it better. Mm-hmm. So right here, I'm inside of the Azure Marketplace, and we have a resource manager template that you can actually start to use to configure. Now, these will be used to spin up a virtual machine in the next step and create your Windows Virtual Desktop tenant. I'll go ahead and click Create here. I'll select my usage profile, and I can say, hey, is this a low, medium, or high user kind of configuration? It'll automatically size the VMs for your needs. Now, here's where things really get exciting. Before, you needed to use a server OS for multi-session environments, and the client OS was limited to one connected user. You know, it's important to understand that Windows Virtual Desktop is the only license that allows you to run a full Windows 10 desktop in a shared public cloud. Now, in the gallery here, I can choose Windows 10 Enterprise with multi-session support. And here I just add a few tenant and authentication fields. And now we can start the build by clicking Create. All right, now check this out. It's going to take 7 minutes and 39 seconds to fully build out this VDI environment that we just created. If you've ever built out a VDI, a remote desktop services solution in your own data center, you know that this could have taken weeks. Now you have the power of the cloud, unlimited capacity, a simple solution. You can now provision this literally in a couple of minutes.
It's really awesome to see all the progress that the team's made, even since we announced a few months back. And one of the other interesting benefits you get with Windows Virtual Desktop is that you can run Windows 7 desktops in the cloud for up to 3 years without having to pay for extended security updates past the January 14th, 2020 date. Now, this is also going to be really helpful if you've got maybe applications with compatibility issues with Windows 10. And speaking of that, I know that we're doing a lot to automate that application validation and testing. What are we doing now in terms of people that are moving to newer versions of Office and Windows?
Back at Ignite, we announced a new service that we call the Desktop App Assure. This has been one of the most incredible things I think I've worked on in my career, because what this is we're saying we have such high confidence in the rate of compatibility of Windows 10, that we're going to give you a phone number, And if you have any application you think has got a compatibility issue, you actually call my engineering team. We will look at the app. If it's a Windows issue, we're going to fix Windows. If it's an issue with your app, we'll help you fix your app. But this has enabled us to basically put a net below IT that says, hey, you can upgrade to Windows 10 with confidence, with the security that Microsoft is standing and backing you. And if there are any compatibility issues, we're going to fix them.
One of the great things is actually the data we've collected since we've started running the program. So really, a lot of things are very compatible, and we've got a lot of data to prove that.
And you know what? The numbers surprise all of us, to be honest. Mm-hmm. What we have seen is with all the applications that have been brought to us to look at, we are seeing that Windows 10 has a greater than 99.9% compatibility rate with applications coming up from Windows 7. Like, that's unbelievable. So what this means is 0.1% of apps that we have looked at, 0.1% actually have a compatibility issue with Windows 10. That is nothing short of remarkable.
It is totally amazing. Right, and so beyond device management and deployment side of things, what are we doing then to deploy the admin experiences and tooling for Microsoft 365?
So what we focus on is, you know, there used to be 23 different entry points, and we've consolidated those into one entry point now for Microsoft 365 for all types of administrators, you know, with 7 specialist workspaces that allow you to dive deep into those granular settings if you're one of those specialists. All right, so Jeremy, I know you have all of this up and running. Why don't you give us a view?
Great. So this is something that's coming out of preview. We've had this in preview for a few months now, but one of the great things that I can do here, this is really the heart of the admin experience from admin.microsoft.com. It's really your starting point, whatever your role is. Now here I can see that I've got some pinned information here on my dashboard, all the relevant tasks to me on the left-hand navigation. I can click down into any of the granular tasks that I might want to do in terms of managing users or devices, for example. And it's really optimized for all the tasks that I do most because it's been personalized. Now, here, I can also see if I want to, and I want to go into specialist spaces like Teams or SharePoint or Exchange or Azure AD, they're all there. But I want to really show your attention to front and center, protecting sensitive info. These are recommendations that are made for me, tailored specific to my environment. So when I go here, I can go here and view the recommendation, and I can see it's found actually debit and credit cards, passport numbers, things that I should be protecting, and actually lets me create a policy that will actually flag me of these and protect any files that contain the sensitive information. Now, back in this view, I can see that my users are protected, and I can also stay up to date with Office 365 software and see what the licensing state is here and all the mobile app policies that I have out in place. Now, one thing I want to show you that's really cool is in terms of user management. If I go and expand the users navigation item here and go into active users, one of the great things here is we've actually taken all the different user controls that were spread everywhere. And now if I click into Abby, I see that I can do basic account stuff. I can obviously change her password if I need to do that. Also change any of the information around Abby. But then even see things like all the licensing states for the applications. Everything's here. I can, if I want to change the from Office 365 E5 to something else, I can do that right here just in one click. And even mail settings, like even down into the specific workloads, all of that's in one view. So if Abby calls me, I've really got just kind of a one-stop shop to do all of that. For everybody watching, the brand new Admin Center starts rolling out today. Now, two things. If you already have the preview running, you have to do anything. Now, this is going to be the default experience. And if you want to get the experience sooner, before maybe it takes place in your tenant, you can actually log into admin.microsoft.com, turn on the preview, and you'll have this experience right now.
Now, talking about bringing it all together and doing some of the things, let's talk a little bit about some of the things we've done in security. You okay. know, security is a big focus in what we're doing in Microsoft 365. And I'm really excited about one of the things that we're just releasing right now. Because I want to talk to you a little bit about security baselines. You know, now historically, you know, we've worked with governments around the globe. And this work helps us to define what a trusted, secure device is. So a Windows device with Office running in it. Right. And, you know, many, many of the governments around the globe take this set of policies and that's what they've implemented.
And these are pretty powerful. These are hundreds of settings, literally, that you can do through Intune.
Yeah.
And the great thing is the devices don't always have to be domain joined kind of in the past like we might have had with group policy on Active Directory.
Yeah, so this is really, I think, one of these things that organizations are going to love because, you know, rather than having to figure out what a secure PC is, you can just leverage the work that Microsoft has done with governments, okay? All right. So let me just kind of show you the security baselines here. So first, what you're looking at here is, you know, the entry point into the security baselines. Mm-hmm. And the first thing I'm going to do is just kind of click into this. And the first thing that you'll see here is I have to give it a name. So I give it a name and give it a little information, and then I go ahead and I can take a look at all of the different settings. And so here's just a few of them. You know, I can do things like I can set the lock screen, block video screen capturing and autoplay of video. You can see all the BitLocker and browser controls. And there's more controls around connectivity, data protection, virtualization-based security to protect your credentials and with Device Guard. And I'll stop right there, but I could keep going because there are literally hundreds of pre-built settings to get you started. And the nice thing is because they're all cloud-enforced, devices don't have to be domain joined. As you said, you can just get these policies applied to all of your devices immediately. So we're constantly doing these kind of things inside of Microsoft 365 in helping you understand how you can increase your controls, deliver power and intelligence from the cloud to just make it simple for you to modernize the way in which you protect your endpoints.
These are really big updates, and it really shows how we're making it easier to connect to managed experiences, stay up to date, and really save time managing Microsoft 365 services. But if I'm watching this from home, where do I get started?
Well, the first thing, I'd go sign up for the Windows Virtual Desktop. Also, if you're a Microsoft 365 or Office 365 administrator, go enable the new look and feel and start using that integrated console. Mm-hmm. And if you're still on Windows 7 and an older version of Office, go check out the Modern Desktop Deployment Center and follow that deployment wheel, but get upgraded.
Right, and you can find that at aka.ms/howtoshift. Really great recommendations. Thanks for joining us today, Brad. And of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates. And don't forget to hit subscribe and follow us on Twitter. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.